On in the Big 7 poll, Danny Adams and the Northeast Jones Tigers lead the way. Small school poll, Bassfield state champions continue to be number one and will be till somebody beats them. Leakesville number two, North Forest, who hasn't played a game yet. Then comes Lumberton, Mount Olive, Richton, and Seminary. How did your favorite team do?
In the stands, the Yellow Jackets taking on the Trojans early in the first quarter. The Trojans strike quickly on a one-yard plunge by halfback Perry Smith, number 34, 7-0 Trojans early. But just before the end of the first quarter, the Yellow Jackets trying to get something going on offense. Jeff Smith is right here in the quarterback for the Yellow Jackets, and he's picked off by number 44, another football name, Pike Pendowski. Pike, it goes down the field there. That set up the only other score of the half, a two-yard touchdown run coming straight to you on your screen by Perry Smith again. At the half, 14-0 West Marion. The final, West Marion 14, Bassfield 6. All right, those Jackets lose another game, 2-2 on the season. Look at that score. Brookhaven over Hattiesburg, 20. And Richton over Sandhill in a big way, 27-0. 1-1. McGee over South Jones, 35-14. McGee 6, 23. Thriller over there in Lamar County. Bassfield is mad, beating North Pike 40-6. Leakesville, perhaps the unheralded team in this area, 6-0 as we speak, 38-3 winners over win. North Forest versus Bassfield, an important game in Eatonville tonight. And as the cheerleaders yell, we look at the action. Bassfield in yellow. Jeff Allen back to pass, finding Garland fairly free in the end zone. Right here, twists into the end zone. It was 6-0 Bassfield early in Eatonville. Later, the two-point conversion. Number 35, William Harper, will get the ball from Allen and go around the right side here. The two-point conversion is good. It is 8-0, and that would be the winning margin tonight. 8-0 Bassfield, as you see. After a Bassfield fumble, Corey Kroom would get North Forest back in the ballgame. Andy Woodard here, back to pass, finds Kroom in the right flank, and he's coming free after a spin. Corey with a touchdown, 8-6. North Forest chooses to go for the two-point conversion, but does not do it. It stays 8-6, and that was the score at halftime. The field, the team comes back from the halftime locker room, and here's a stop by North Forest here on a Bassfield drive. After 14 plays, they are stopped. And the Eatonville crowd from North Forest is yelling. Right here from the four-yard line, highly recruited running back, David Dawkins, number 25, goes 40 yards down the field before he is corralled here. But that would be the only threat for North Forest on this night in the second half, the final. North Forest a loser to Bassfield, 8-6 as you see it. Bassfield leaves that district race. Now, North Forest and Bassfield weren't in the same district last year, but this year they are. And that is a very important ball game. As Bassfield wins this last district game, they will be the district winners and will go on to the South State playoffs. For North Forest, they must hope for a Bassfield loss. The Golden Eagles are a big night, unusually, in high school football with Bassfield and North Forest. They're so closely oriented together. They're two good football teams, and it's sad to see a loser, and they lose by only 2 points, and the loser probably won't be going to the state playoffs. So it's kind of sad, but it was a good game. It was my first high school game I did get to go to, so I enjoyed it. Okay. And on tomorrow, we'll preview all our big university games, Ole Miss. Howard Willoughby and his staff looking on Bassfield versus Ackerman. Jackets in yellow. William Harper sweeps the right side to the 10 and on to the end zone. Look at that speed, number 32. The two-point conversion made it 8-0 Bassfield early, and that would be the tell of the tape later. Now in the first quarter, we'll show you another score. It's Harper again, coming off the veer play here, 5 yards away. You get the picture. It was 24-3 at the half, Bassfield. The final, Bassfield 32, Ackerman 12. As you'll see it, Bassfield, the Jackets, the winner. And another score for you, South Leak bombarding Taylorsville. What a way to end your season, 52-10. The cheerleaders from McLean. Eagles come back in the second half like they did last week against Prentice. They came back in the second half. Bassfield, a winner over South Leak, 36-14. Those Jackets, you can count on them in the postseason. Leakesville, a winner over East Florida, 17-14. East Florida was the number one ranked AA team in the state. Leakesville, a winner. Park Lane Academy out of Macomb, a winner in the Academy Class 3A Championship, 7-6. Mendenhall shuts out Florence, 30-0. One more score for you. Again, I say two. Moss Point, 20. Good evening, everyone. Our trivia question this evening. Freeze's first name. What is it? Be the first to call and win a Mitch Williams trivia t-shirt if you want one. That a familiar scene to you? Bassfield High School scoring a touchdown in the playoffs. Well, if you're a Yellow Jacket fan, you expect to see touchdowns around this time. Coach Howard Willoughby has a team that will play Leakesville Friday for the right to play in the Class 2A championship game. A note, the Jackets have not lost to a Class 2A squad since 1983. The 1986 team lost two of its first four games, and folks didn't think the Jackets would survive to defend its state title.
We had a lot of pressure put us on at the first of the year, and I think it kind of got to us. But after we lost those two, we kind of relaxed a little, and we started to improve, and we've been improving ever since.
The Bassfield-Leakesville contest will be the last game played by Leakesville High School at home. Leakesville High will consolidate next year. Do you blame us? This week, there's no prep of the week. I'm sorry, folks. Turkeys in November comes pigskin, both from the NFL and on the collegiate level. So if you love football, then you look forward to Thanksgiving so you can eat, sit back, and watch television. Bassfield Friday night, the Yankees are talking to a former Cy Young Award winner, and McEnroe is in a little trouble. But our team has stopped Bassfield from going to the Class 2A championship game in 3 years, and oh, what a sweet win it could be. The Bears have been up and down all season, but it seemingly is on track just in time for the playoffs. Leakesville has an awesome defense, one that averages about 210 pounds on the defensive line. Yes, high school. Bassfield coach Howard Willoughby says his team has had its troubles against good defenses.
Well, we've had our trouble with big teams that have good defenses. We like to score a lot of points. You know, West Marion gave us a lot of trouble and won their ball game. East Marion was the same thing, and Utica. The three ball games we've lost with two teams with good defenses.
Friday's game is at 7:30 in Leakesville. The Bears have turned around since losing to North Forest 17-0. The Jackets have took off since beating the Eagles 8-6. As in every Turkey Day, an annual Thanksgiving run is given belt family-wide, and the sports...
In overtime, the Yellow Jackets will now make their third straight trip to the state championships. Let's take a look at some of the last night's highlights. We go to Leakesville, and it was very rainy and nasty. Bassfield scored first on a second quarter keeper by the quarterback. Went in 2 points, conversion, it was 8-0. Now here's how you do it. Ollie Johnson for Leakesville carries people into the end zone, and it's 8-8. You can see how foggy and cloudy and bad it was out there. Second half, Bassfield drives down the field. Number 35 sweeps the corner left side, and he scores. That made it 16-8. But look at this play come up. Leakesville, on the quarterback pass, he drops it. People thought it was down, but no, he throws it. That was Michael Matthews to Ollie Johnson, wide open. That goes into the end zone. They tie it at 18-18, but Bassfield comes back to win the ball game in overtime, 24-23. I'll tell you, it was a nasty night out there.
It did look bad out there. I understand you're going to be at the Biloxi gym tonight.
I'll be at the gym tonight. They'll take on...
Jackets are working in preparation for Saturday afternoon's 2A State High School football championship game against Baldwin. Bassfield is the two-time defending state champion. After losing two of their first four games, the Jackets have racked up 9 straight wins. Even Willoughby thought his young team would have an off year, but now finds that same young team going for the gold again.
Well, I'm scared. I know the pressure's on us, and I know Baldwin has a good football team, and you just don't go on forever. I just would like to get this one, though.
That's Howard Willoughby.
Win number 3 in a row. Well, they have to face a tough Baldwin team, one much stronger and more talented than the one the Jackets beat 2 years ago for the crown. The Bassfield cheerleaders led a rather loud pep rally at the high school this afternoon, but the players didn't seem too excited at all. Look at that bunch. Then again, Bassfield football players always look that way, confident. Coach Howard Willoughby talks about his opponent Saturday afternoon.
I think they have a more balanced attack this year. Mm-hmm. They have two good running backs they utilize a lot, and they have a quarterback that can throw the football. They like to throw the backs coming out of the backfield.
As opposed to playing at nighttime, you know, you got to play during the day. Does it help you or hinder you or what?
I don't think it'll make any difference because we do all our practicing during the daylight hours. Mm-hmm. If it was later on, if it was early in the season, it might make a difference, but not this time. Well, I believe I'd rather play, maybe it's a little warmer in the daytime.
News 7 Sports will salute Bassfield in a special 30-minute program at 10:30, and it's called Bassfield the Third Time Around. Please tune in. A Dallas publication quotes Cowboy running.
The Bassfield Yellow Jackets won their third successive state championship this afternoon by downing Baldwin 18-7. This afternoon's victory makes Bassfield the first team in state history to win three consecutive crowns. Mitch was in Clinton today and filed this report.
Title number three for these seniors. Three Class 2A championship rings for Garland Fairley and Jeff Allen, and they haven't been measured for their senior class rings yet. Oddly, these seniors had a sophomore on their squad that would lead them to their place in history. With no score in the second quarter, Bourbon Womack, as I've said, a sophomore, drops the Baldwin quarterback. The ball is loose. Willie Reeves, a 210-pound tackle, picks it up and runs toward the end zone. Reese taken down at the four-yard line, and the Bassfield fans went crazy. From the four, Jeff Allen found John Stringer for six. The PAT no good, Jackets up early. After a short Baldwin punt, Womack did his end on the offensive side. Womack going up the middle, spinning and cutting for 18 yards and six more. Coach Howard Willoughby and his team went into the locker room with a 12-0 lead. Baldwin scored a touchdown early in the fourth quarter to make the score 12-7, but Womack would put it out of reach for Coach Howard Tucker and his Bearcats. Womack up the middle for 45 yards to the 10-yard line before he is brought down. From there, William Harper goes in for six more. 18-7 was enough to win for the third time.
Touchdown, Yellow Jackets.
I thought that when the turning point in the ball game was when Willie Reese picked up that fumble and almost scored. I carried down to about the 4-yard line.
Did you think after the East Mary loss that you'd come this far?
No, I didn't have any dream I'd be here.
So is the third one sweeter than the first two, you think?
Well, they all sweet. I don't have any prep.
Willie, he's one outstanding coach all around. I can't say nothing about him. He's just terrific.
What are you gonna do once you get back to Bassfield?
Oh, I'm gonna have me a good time.
We'll salute Bassfield's third successive crown in a special Sunday night show at 10:30. It's Bassfield the third time around. In Clinton, Mitchell Williams, News 7 Sports.
Class 2A football champions, the first team in the state's history to win three consecutive state championships. Mitchell Williams will host that tribute to Coach Howard Willoughby and his amazing Yellow Jackets. And Connie, we want everybody to stick around for that because it's going to be a real good special. I think everybody will enjoy it.
Really makes me want to stick around for
sure.
It. Okay, thank you. And we really enjoyed having Mark.
If one goes to a Bassfield football game, he or she immediately sees these signs sitting adjacent to the football field. A football field all dusty, nothing but dirt, not much grass at all. But oh, do the Jackets play football. Good evening, everyone. Mitch Williams here telling you about Bassfield. The Yellow Jackets go to the state championship game for the third consecutive time in hopes for a crown. Do they? Will they? Is it a dynasty? We'll tell you about it tonight as our special continues here on Channel 7, Bassfield, the third time around.
Holiday greeting.
After four football games into the 86 season, Bassfield High School was not like the two previous Jefferson Davis County champs in the fact that they would be undefeated and hardly scored upon. Bassfield lost to Class A Power Utica and had its troubles against West Marion, a team that would finish the regular season at 8-2. The magic just wasn't there. Ways to win were hard to come by.
Well, we've had our trouble with big teams that have good defenses. We like to score a lot of points. You know, West Marion gave us a lot of trouble and won their ball game. East Marion was the same thing. And Utica, the three ball games we've lost with two teams with good defenses.
Bassfield would win their next three contests, including a big win against Highway 42 neighbor Summerall. And seemingly things began to fall in place for the veteran Willoughby and his Jackets. Touchdowns were plentiful. The Yellow Jacket defense was stinging again, and the atmosphere had the smell of 84 and 85 championship seasons. But then came East Marion the next week, a team not noted for doing well the past few years, but was undefeated in 86. The final tally, East Marion 18, Bassfield 14. The Jackets were now at 500. And one can't remember the last time a Jacket team had as many losses as wins at any time during a season. Some Bassfield fans were discouraged and a small bit embarrassed. In practice next week, Coach Howard Willoughby stressed more fundamentals, and in that, enthusiasm reappeared. You could hear the yelling from a mile away. From the cradle, these young bunch of football players started to begin preparation for the second part of the football season.
Look at Jordan.
In the ninth contest of the season, Bassfield would meet North Forest. It had been a while since the two had met in the regular season. The contest would hold playoff hopes in the balance. The Mississippi High School Activities Association had put the two schools in the same district in 86, so the winner would be the odds-on favorite to be the district champion.
We can't let them have the big plays. We've got to be able to move the football offensively, and you can't give them the long 50, 60-yard touchdown runs on kickoff, punt returns, and, you know, breaking them from the line of scrimmage. And if you can contain them like that, you got a good chance of beating them.
Only 14 points would be scored in this game, and miscues happened throughout the night. The Jackets got on the board first, John Stringer hauling this pass in from quarterback Jeff Allen to put Bassfield up 6-0. The two-point conversion was good. Bourbon Womack, only a sophomore, takes it in. After seemingly, though, gaining the momentum, Bassfield fumbles, and the homestanding Eagles take it to the Bassfield goal line. Corey Crooms' touchdown made it an 8-6 ball game. The players didn't know it, but the contest would be won on this missed two-point conversion by the Eagles that looked oh so close. Bassfield was helped by a number of errors by North Forest, errors that could have easily changed the game around and the outcome. North Forest would be stopped in the playoffs by Bassfield again for the third consecutive year. And in the words of Eagle coach Alton Waltman, it seems to be a jinx. True enough, the 8-6 win over North Forest gave the Jackets the needed momentum for success in the playoffs. Bassfield crushed Taylorsville 48-6 in their last regular season game and went on from there to prepare themselves for their opening playoff game against Ackerman. Indeed, Bassfield was winning.
I was on the ground when I needed a hand, and it couldn't be found. I was so far down that I couldn't get up. You know, and what I had to do was
across the Jackets and a host of other area schools to practice indoors, the Jackets in their recreational center. The yelling was louder, the kids were lively and ready to compete. Despite some nagging injuries, optimism ran high and deep that Bassfield would return to the playoffs. Against Ackerman, Bassfield had a 3-touchdown lead at halftime. It was no contest, and really, it was hard to believe a team like Ackerman made it to the playoffs. The onslaught continued. Bassfield would beat South League 34-16. South League, a team that beat Taylorsville the week before 52-6. The journey to Clinton would have to come through Leakesville. The Bears sat awaiting after upsetting the state's highest-ranked team, East Flora.
They have a good offense. They run the ball well. They can mix their passing game in with their running game. I think their big plus is their defense.
Just terrible conditions in Leakesville on this night. It had rained the whole week. In fact, flash flood watches were everywhere in the state. Bassfield got on top early with Jeff Allen's quarterback sneak with a 2-point conversion, 8-0 Jackets. But Leakesville scored 8 to tie it at the half. The second half brought overtime. 16 points apiece was the score in Mississippi High School football. You get 4 downs to put it in. Leakesville scores 6 on third down and kicked the PAT. The Jackets score 6 on fourth down in inches and made the 2-point conversion to become the last football team to beat Leakesville, who would consolidate next season. It was on to Clinton for Bassfield. Another shot for a state title. A chance to become the state's first 3-time winner. Bassfield a third time around.
Quality furniture.
After Bassfield's win over Leakesville, the town of Bassfield, located in Jefferson Davis County on Highway 42, started getting prepared for a big football game in Clinton. Yes, those Jackets were still playing. This is being the first part of December. They say that they don't start playing till November. The cheerleaders start singing. The football players start practicing even harder in practice. Oh, the town, well, they start getting prepared for another football game, perhaps another championship, and optimism was just about everywhere. Downtown Bassfield is made of just a few stores all accumulated together. The tallest building is this, the Caraway General Store, and often Bassfield residents gather to talk about their winning football team. Do you ever go to any of these football games right here?
Yeah. Yes.
What do you think about Bassfield?
A good team.
Why are they a good football team?
It's best.
What do you think about Bassfield?
I think it's the most wonderful place I've ever known. I've lived here so many years, it's home.
Mm-hmm. What about the football team?
We got the best. We got the best.
Why does everybody follow this football team?
Well, because we love the boys, we love the player, we love all everything about the football team. We love our coach, too. We're for Bassfield. We love Bassfield, too.
You think Bassfield gonna win?
Yeah, I think they're gonna win. If they win this far, they're gonna go all the way.
What, you gonna go to the ball game?
Mm-hmm.
Why are you gonna go to the basketball game for?
Because that's the football game I wanna go to.
Mm-hmm. You gonna wear black and gold?
Mm-hmm.
How old are you?
8.
How long have you been going to football games?
I think since I was a baby.
Since you were a baby, you've been going to Bassfield High football games?
Mm-hmm. Sure have.
Your mom and daddy go to all of them, too?
See, he's the coach.
Your daddy's the coach? Who's your daddy?
Eddie Huff.
Coach Huff is your daddy? And he's assistant coach with Coach Willoughby, right?
Right.
And he goes to all the games, huh? And he's been taking you ever since you were a baby?
Yes, sir.
How you like that?
I like it.
What's your mama say about it?
Well, she likes it, too, I think.
You're a Bassfield Yellow Jacket fan?
Right.
Why?
Well, I live here.
that's what most people say. Just because they live here, they support Bassfield High football. But that don't mean you got to go to the football games, does it?
Yeah, man, when you live here, you know you got to support them.
Why does this football team win all the time?
They just good, I reckon. That's all I can say about it.
You think it might be the coach?
Yeah, they got a good coach. I agree with that. They got a good coach.
What do you know about Bassfield? You think the Yellow Jackets going to win?
Number one.
Why they number one? Why everybody support Bassfield?
Well, because we got a good team. We got discipline. We got a good school. And that's why we're number one. That's the reason we're going to the state 3 years in a row.
What do you think about the coach?
Oh, we got a terrific coach. That's when he was coach of the year for the last couple of years. He's number one, too.
So I expect you to be in Clinton on
Friday. I'll be there.
Thank you. How are you, Kelly?
11.
You know anything about Bassfield football?
They're good.
They're good, huh? Why are they so good? You go to about all the games?
Just about it.
Why? Do you go to your mom and daddy?
Sometimes I go with Christian now.
Mm-hmm. And then you get out there in that cold and look at them play football?
Yes, sir.
Do you enjoy it?
Yes, sir.
Hmm? You don't never get cold? You do? But it still don't make you leave.
Hi.
You like Bassfield?
Yes, I do.
Do you go to their football games?
Yes, when I can.
When you can, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Have you been to any this year?
Yes.
How many have you been to this year?
About four.
About four of them?
Mm-hmm.
You going to Clinton?
I'm not planning on going. It's going to be too cold.
It's going to be too cold? That's going to keep you from seeing no Jackets play football?
Yes. When that wind start hitting your legs, they're going to think twice.
I hear you.
Uh-huh, I know.
But you think they're going to win anyway?
Oh, they're going to win. They're going to win.
What do you know about Bassfield football? Do they have a pretty good team? I guess they do, right?
Yeah, from over the past years' experience, they got an excellent team. I got a lot of faith in them.
You follow them around?
Well, I work offshore, but every chance I get, I reckon I've been at every game while I was at home over the last 7 or 8 years.
My goodness. Why do all these people follow Bassfield? I mean, what's the difference? You know, you see a lot of towns, they don't support their football team like Bassfield does.
Well, I reckon when you got a good team, you got something to support.
Mm-hmm.
And I reckon they've been able to back up, you know, their team, you know, because they can do what they're supposed to do. I reckon it's third year in a row, and I reckon they're going to... I'm looking forward to do it tonight.
So you know they're going to do it, huh?
I'm pretty positive.
Would you bet the house?
Yeah, I would.
All right. Meantime, at the high school, things went as usual. Nothing really out of the ordinary. It was like any other day before a Bassfield football game. It was like people just knew the Jackets were going to win. Bassfield coach Howard Willoughby walked with his physical education classes to the pep rally, as he has done for the past 10 years. No heebie-jeebies for this man. At the pep rally, the cheerleaders were their noisy selves, as always.